What's up, Grio fam? It's your girl, Natasha S. Alford. And today on the Grio, we have Dania Diaz, the managing director of Team Roc. You know all about The Rock, Sean Carter, Jay-Z, some people call him Hove, but they're doing incredible work in the world and particularly in the area of social justice. And we're so excited about the United Justice Coalition's first ever social justice convention. This is going to be a game changer. And so welcome to the show, Dania. Thank you so much for talking with us about this.
Thank you so much, Natasha. Really appreciate being here.
Absolutely. So first, let's talk about the why. What was the vision behind bringing together some of the biggest names in criminal justice reform and media to talk about social justice?
Well, I'd like to kind of anchor that with first, what Team Roc does at Roc Nation. And so, and you mentioned that we are the social justice division, philanthropic division. And we learned very early on in all of our work that, you know, the power of the collective is so much greater. So in 2019, we just decided to call friends, colleagues, experts in the field, and just kind of brought all these people together. And at the time, we just called it a meeting of the minds, and later it became this formal organization now known as the United Justice Coalition with experts from all different fields, right? We have entertainment, we have folks representing the legal profession, civil rights attorneys, social activists and organizers and educators, et cetera. And we just gather to talk about issues and really start to think about what is the best way to pull our resources together to change policy, to amplify issues that are really concern us, which are really centered around justice.
Absolutely. And I love this idea of a meeting of the minds and coming together, right? Because we often have conversations in silos in different industries, but you're bringing people together. Some of the names that we're excited to see on the agenda for the convention: Ben Crump, Yo Gotti, Dr. Michael Eric Dyson, New York Attorney General Letitia James, Dr. Bernice King. I mean, this is intergenerational, again, many different industries together. When people come together at the summit, what can they expect? What will they see, and what do you want people to experience?
Our vision was really about, and that's, you just underscored that, right? It's the collaboration. It is a meeting of the minds. It's a cross-section of expertise, of concerned citizens. It's intergenerational. And that's what we want to really emphasize, that this is going to be a place for everyone, regardless of background, to take action. And so one of the things that will happen upon entry is exposure to over 40 organizations from across the nation. We're talking about organizations that are coming from Alabama and Memphis and California, incredible organizations that are doing on the ground work. And then on top of that, we'll have these really powerful conversations that will be running throughout the day. So we will be talking about conditions of confinement, the decriminalization of mental health, mental illness, rather, the voices of families that have been impacted by police violence. So we'll have, Dr. Tiffany Crutcher and Alyssa Findy and Michelle Kenny and Dr. Bernice A. King be part of this family conversation, as well as the mother of Eric Garner, Gwen Carr. We'll also talk about the transitions in and out of the system, everything from police contact to reentry, so pretrial detention, probation and parole, what are alternatives to sentencing. We'll talk about wrongful conviction as well, and how do we bridge the divide when we're talking about policing in America? What are some real ways that people can take action to be part of this need and desire for us to kind of turn the tide of where this country is going right now?
Yeah, there's a lot happening in this country. What's interesting is that many artists, and hip hop artists in particular, find themselves on the front lines of this fight for criminal justice reform. Many of them end up being targets, or they end up being caught up in the system. Are there any artists who you've been really proud of or inspired by their social justice engagement that come to mind from Roc Nation?
Obviously, our founder, Mr. Carter, is just so deeply dedicated and is such a champion for justice. And I'd have to also highlight, one person who's really going to be on our panel, Yo Gotti, you mentioned him, you know, from the very beginning. He's somebody who has been such a champion for prison reform and really, really held a torch up for, bringing light to the situation at Parchment Farms, which is, as you know, through the work of Team Roc and certainly through the advocacy and support of the United Justice Coalition, we were able to really get some movement from the Department of Justice through our investigative reports, through our amplification. Of course, there were dozens of organizations that have been working on this, but they have now declared that Parchment Prison, really, the conditions there violate the 8th and 14th Amendment, which is huge. So that's, I'd have to say, you know, having a voice like Yo Gotti's has really helped to kind of bring it to a larger public.
For sure, that's real impact. And I remember interviewing Yo Gotti when he was talking about that story and trying to bring awareness to what was happening. I'm so interested in the shifting tides, right, of public opinion. There was this one moment where it felt like the country was on the same page about criminal justice reform. No matter your politics, we have to make change. And now we've seen sort of a shift as crime has increased, and you know, you're hearing a lot of sort of anti-bail reform messages and people who are very critical of reform efforts to try to, you know, rehabilitate and give people a second chance. Do you see this gathering as part of the education of the nation, so to speak? Like, do you see it as part of a greater educational effort to show people that criminal justice reform is not just about letting people off the hook?
Absolutely. I think that's certainly one of the key goals, right? And throughout the day, our hope is that you come out of there feeling much more educated about these issues, inspired, and really feel like you have real pathways to make a difference. You may not always agree with the perspective, but it's important to get to a place where you have an understanding of what the issues are from sort of like a 360 view. And then figure out and make an informed decision about how you want to take action. And so that's really kind of the spirit behind this as well, that it's not just preaching to the choir, right? It's really about getting diverse perspectives, really learning, really listening to one another and figuring out, okay, where can we make change and how quickly can we do that? Because we need to act very quickly.
Yeah, the need is so urgent. Every day a new story. You know, if you're from the New York tri-state area, you hear about Rikers and the conditions there, and they're just awful. And many people who are there are also innocent, right? Or they're mm-hmm. waiting trial and they don't deserve to suffer those inhumanities. You have been a leader in this space for some time, working with the Sean Carter Foundation, working in education. I'm curious for you, what has been like inspirational lesson of working for Mr. Carter, right? Working for this team, Roc Nation or Team Roc. What do you think you've learned from him and his like vision for change in the world?
I always say this, that nothing is impossible. It's something that I've really, really learned from him, from being here, from our leadership here. It takes a lot of courage to be the first to walk through the door, you know, and sometimes you may get beaten down a bit, but if it opens the door for others, then it's worth it. And I think that that's really been just the blessing of being here, really just really feeling like nothing is impossible. And you really start to believe that and feel it and live it. And it just becomes greater the more support that you have and the more people who join you on this journey.
Yes, nothing is impossible. Dania Diaz, thank you so much. Was there anything else that I did not ask that you'd like the world to know about this special event coming up this weekend?
I want people to come to tune in. And if you can't make it physically, we will just to continue to follow our socials because we will continue to build upon this. This is not going to be the first and last. This will become a destination event in the future. The issues are too important, and that is the goal. And we want people to connect to the greater purpose of all this.
For sure. GRIO family, make sure you show up. It's the first ever sponsored by the United Justice Coalition. And of course, Team Roc, Dania Diaz, Managing Director of Team Roc. Thank you so much for your work and the brilliance of, you know, making this come to life. And GRIO family, you can go to thegrio.com to learn more about the convention. We hope to see you there. Take care, everybody.
Thank you. Appreciate you, Natasha.